A day after the Solicitor General Mohan Parasaran went on record for the very first time to distance the government from the Law Minister, clearly passing the buck now to the CBI in the Colgate cover-up, the BJP outrightly rejected the Solicitor General's argument, clearly stating that the Prime Minister, his staff and the Coal Ministry all are possible targets of investigation.
They had first staunchly backed the Law Minister, but now the government trying to distance the Prime Minister from Ashwini Kumar, whose mention in the CBI's affidavit on Colgate has put them in a tight spot. This explosive Colgate interview, the first on-record statement from a top government law officer, has sparked a debate.
The Prime Minister was only concerned that the truth should be told to the court, and the court should not get any impression that actually there was something which is being hidden from it. In fact, the Prime Minister has so many duties. He is not directly monitoring as to what is happening in his office in minute detail.
Government's top legal officer, Solicitor General Mohan Parasaran, even trying to downplay the Law Minister's meetings with the CBI.
There could not have been political interference in presence of responsible law officers of the country. If the Law Minister wanted to politically interfere, he could have called the CBI director separately.
But the opposition continues to train its gun on the Prime Minister, refusing to buy the Solicitor General's argument.
The Prime Minister's office or the Prime Minister or the Coal Ministry officials may not be accused as yet, but they are certainly suspects in this case. They are possible targets of investigation. They are the ones who took the decision.
As the crucial Supreme Court hearing on the coal scam draws closer, the UPA government pulling all stops to firefight the deepening crisis. But with the opposition turning on the heat, the political fight is far from over. Bureau Report, Times Now.